A good girl.
Like, in what sense, good girl?
She doesn't hurt others.
Her duty is all she lives for.
Someone who's caring, someone who shares, someone who loves.
Independent.
Being sweet, being nice.
Traditionally, a good girl is supposed to be very, you know, docile, soft. She's supposed to wear a dress which covers her whole body.
Usually the ones who sit in the first benches are usually good girls. That is how the society has been teaching us and even the teachers and everybody.
There's no particular standard definition of good or bad. What is good to me can be bad to you.
Parents say that you should be in marriage, our opinion is not a opinion.
I really don't know what a good girl really means. I'm not too sure about it.
Every girl is a good girl.
Good girl वो है जो parents की बात अच्छी तरह से सुनती है और अपनी दिमाग से भी कुछ कर सकती है कि कोई उसे blame ना करे आप यहाँ गए वहाँ गए.
If we live within the generally accepted generally accepted things, then it will be good.
हर एक लड़की तो गुड ही होती है. ऐसा नहीं कि वो लड़की अपने आप को बैड समझती हैं या गुड समझती हैं. सभी अपने आप को गुड ही समझते हैं.
Society has a certain unwritten and written rules that keeps changing from time to time. Civilization based on the culture. So someone who adheres to those written rules or unwritten rules forms more into conformity with what society expects her.
Good girls learn certain things and good girls speak in a certain way or laugh in a certain way, which I think are quite pointless because, I mean, who wants to be a good girl? It's pretty boring, no?
Bad girl.
Actually, there are many ways to define a bad girl.
Sluts.
Discos.
Flirts with guys.
Responsible.
Those at the back benches are too bold.
Smokes, drinks, then goes on for party after night.
Bitching.
Having multiple boyfriends.
I don't think that is the bad girl nature.
I don't believe there's any such thing as a bad girl.
Somebody who lives by what others say, I would say that's a bad girl.
What a bad girl does may seem wrong to most of the society.
You are probably clubbing and I think that is not good. It could be my perspective that she's a bad girl.
Most of the time it's a perspective.
No, nobody is bad girl anymore in nowadays. Everyone lives in their own way.
Bad girl is somebody who fails to achieve everything that goes into a good girl.
Actually, clothes should not play a role, but apparently nowadays it's so happening that the girls were wearing, a short skirt or a sleeveless and a thin thing. Probably it's provoking boys or men. That should not be the situation, but unfortunately it is happening.
Certain people have got to say that girls who dress which covers less parts of their body are supposed to be sluts. That is the word that they use. But that is absolutely the girl's choice.
Let's see, I don't say a good girl based on her dressing sense.
Their dressing should be in such a way that it should not attract any comments or any sort of unwanted attention from others.
Clothes don't come into picture of good and bad for you. But then it depends on the person. If she thinks it is bad, then essentially it becomes bad.
मिनीज स्लीवलेस बैकलेस वगैरह ऐसे सब पहने तो वहाँ पे एक पॉइंट जाता है ऑब्वियसली नज़र पड़ेगी नहीं दिखने वाला भी देखेगा नमक इष्टम पड़ी मतवक नम कवर ड्रेस पड़कूड़ा ड्रेस पड़े डीसंटा पड़ी अगर ड्रेस पाती तेरह मारे पड़ा எல்லா நாம தப்பா நினைப்பாங்க இந்த பொண்ணு தப்பாப்பட்ட பொண்ணுன்னு நினைப்பாங்க
கேர்ள் ஷுட் வேர் அ ரைட் க்ளோத்ஸ் லைக் இட் ஷுட் நாட் பி அ ஃப்ரீ ஷோ ஆஃப் ஆப்வியஸ்லி இட் அட்ராக்ட் பாய்ஸ் And then what I believe is girl should cover herself and should wear a sensible clothing. especially in colleges, while going in offices, there should be a sense of dressing.
According to her, it's correct. Some of the men, even though you're fully clothed, you can feel how they are looking through your clothes. That apart, maybe you shouldn't be wearing too revealing clothes. Otherwise, I think, allowable degree, women can wear whatever they want to wear.
To be honest, I mean, what a woman wears is up to a woman. So I don't think anybody has any business to comment on it.
The girl has a choice to wear the clothes that she wants to wear. And if she is aware of the repercussions of wearing such clothes, who are we to question whether she's good or bad?
I don't judge, I don't criticize any people according to their facial expression or it may be a dressing style. I cannot judge because we do not know their what is her heart.
You can't stop people from looking at you or staring at you or any of that. So when you are dressing, at least when I am dressing, I make sure that, I feel comfortable. I don't want someone to look at me like all the time. So that's what I feel.
Clothes, it's an addition to who you are. So whatever you wear, you should be basically comfortable in it. I mean, you shouldn't be checking yourself out all the time to see if it's coming up or, what is being shown. So as long as you can do that, I think you should be able to wear whatever you want.
I'm also a guy, but I never look into that, you know.
ಬಟ್ಟೆ ಹಾಕ್ಕೊಳ್ಳೋದ್ರಲ್ಲಿ ಏನು ತೊಂದರೆನೇ ಇಲ್ಲ, ನಾವು ನೋಡೋದು ದೃಷ್ಟಿಯಲ್ಲಿದೆ. ಬಟ್ಟೆ ಅನ್ನೋದು ಮಕ್ಕಳಿಂದ ಹಿರಿಯರ ತನಕ ಹಾಕ್ತಾರೆ, ಅದು ಅವರವರು ಇಷ್ಟ ಪ್ರಕಾರ ಹಾಕ್ಬೋದು, ಅದೆಲ್ಲ ನಾವು ಕಂಟ್ರೋಲ್ ಮಾಡೋಕ್ಕಾಗಲ್ಲ, ಅವ್ರ ಮನಸ್ಸಿಗೆ ಬಂದಂಗೆ ಅವ್ರು ನಡ್ಕೊಳ್ತಾರೆ.
ಇಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಅನ್ ಇಂಪ್ಯಾಕ್ಟ್ ಬಟ್ ನಾಟ್ ದಿಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ದ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಥಿಂಗ್ ವಿಚ್ ಡಿಟರ್ಮೈನ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಮೈ ಮೈಂಡ್. ಐ ವುಡ್ ಡೆಫಿನೆಟ್ಲಿ ನಾಟ್ ಗಿವ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಮಚ್ ಆಫ್ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಟು ಕ್ಲೋತ್ ಆಸ್ ಸಚ್ ಟು ಬಿಗಿನ್ ವಿತ್, ಬಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಅನ್ ಇಂಪ್ಯಾಕ್ಟ್, ಐ ಕಾಂಟ್ ಡಿನೈ ದಟ್.
ಸ್ಯಾರಿ ಕಟ್ಟನೋ, மெடி போடலாம், பேண்ட் ஷர்ட் போடக்கூடாது, சுடிதார் போடலாம்.
அது ட்ரெஸ்ஸு போடலாம் எதுவும் ப்ராப்ளம் கிடையாது, அவங்க பார்க்குற விதத்தில் இருக்குது. இப்போ ஜென்ஸு பார்க்குறாங்கன்னா ஒவ்வொருத்தர் வந்து நல்ல அது வந்து எதுவும் கேர் பண்ணிக்கிறது இல்லை. ஒவ்வொருத்தர் வந்து இன்னும் இந்த மாதிரி ட்ரெஸ் போட்டிருக்காங்களே அவங்கள பார்த்து நம்ம கிண்டல் பண்ணலாம், ஏதாவது கேலியாக பேசுவாங்க, கிண்டலாக பேசுவாங்க.
கவிங் த பாடி ஃபுல்லி, மத்லப் டோன்ட் ஷோயிங் இட் எவ்ரி திங்.
ஓதுற யங்ஸ்டரை கரெக்டாக வைப்போம், கரெக்டாக பார்க்கும், அது என் மடது இல்லை, நம்ம மாற்றி கிளது இல்லை. ட்ரெஸ்ஸிங் வாக்கவுண்டது ஃபுல் பட்டாங்க கொண்டாங்குது, நான் எழுதுறா கிளையல, யாரும் கிளையல, அப்பா மற்ற கேள்விப்பாக்கு, என் தங்கியும் மகளும் யாரோ இல்லையே கேள்விப்பாக்கு கிளதில்ல.
அப்சல்யூட்லி, க்ளோத்ஸ் ஆர் அன் இம்பார்ட்டன்ட் கான்ட்ரிபியூட்டிங் ஃபேக்டர் டு எனி கைண்ட் ஆஃப் டிஸ்கஷன் ஆன் விமன், பிகாஸ் ஃபார் சம் ரீசன் தர் சம் கிரேட் மிஸ்டிக் பவர் இன் ஆர் பாடிஸ். ஓகே, ஐ மீன் look at us, all of us have the same set of equipment, so to speak, but we seem to, there's some great power in them, because if you wear clothes, then you're attractive. If you don't wear clothes, you are attractive. If you wear certain kind of clothes which are less, then also you're attractive. If you wear too many clothes, even then you're attractive. So I don't know, I mean, it's kind of pointless, but it's there. Good girls are the ones who completely desexualizes themselves. You wear loose clothes so that your feminine parts are not visible.
Har ek ladki ko har ek cheez pehnne ki khwahish hoti, to aisa nahi ki oh chalo ye pehn liye to mujhe ye khwahish nahi hai, to har ek ladke ko main isme kaise lagungi, sabko bhi ye khwahish hoti. Wo dikhne ke upar depends hota hai, kaun kaisi nazar se dikhta hai uske upar depend hota hai. तो आदमी लोग क्या कहते हैं, ड्रेसिंग को देख के वो गलत है, वो गंदी है, वैसा नहीं बोल सकते, उसकी ख्वाहिश है, उसका पसंद है.
Sexual harassment is something that none of us can personally tolerate.
We see sexual harassment everywhere, in buses and all those things. So what is happening? They keep commenting, stalking and all those.
There is two things. One is the helplessness of the person, and I guess one is almost a conspiracy of silence in the people around who are supposed to be supportive to them.
It's a very, very heinous crime, which is seriously disgusting.
Sexual harassment, rape, I think our society is still not convinced with these two words, or you know, it is still very fiery to some of those families to talk about rape or to talk about sexual harassment in houses. And at society, we are not exposed to such things, and we don't know how you should treat some women in front of you, because we are always taught not to talk to girls.
First, it's responsible for the girl. It's her duty to keep herself, like, protect. It should be like, she should know at this time I should not go there. Like, if she's going there, something she should protect her. Like, she should wear, like, full jackets, full sleeves.
நிறைய செக்ஸ் படம் பார்க்குறது செக்ஸாக நடக்கிறது தொட்டு ஆம்பளைங்களுக்கும் அது மாதிரி தோடுது செய்கிறாங்க. பொம்பளைங்களும் கொஞ்சம் துணி போட வேண்டியது தான் மாடலுன்னு, ஆனால் கொஞ்சம் நல்லா ரீசனாக போட்டுனு போனால் ஆம்பளைங்களுக்கும் அது மாதிரி தோணாது.
When a rape happens, there is no point in blaming, you know, why a girl was at a particular place at a particular point of time or what she was wearing. The bottom line is that she has been raped. Somebody has touched all over her body and done brutal things to her.
ஆண்கள் மேலே தான் தப்பு, ஆண்கள் மேலே தான் தப்பு. ஏன்னா இந்த நடக்கிறது வந்து குழந்தை மேலே தான் பண்ணுறாங்க. 2.5 குழந்தை, 3 குழந்தைலாம் பாலியல் வன்முறை நடக்குது. அதுமாதிரிலாம் குழந்தை மேலே சொல்ல முடியாது. 18-20 வயசு மேலே பொண்ணுங்க தப்பு பண்ணால் அவங்க மேலே தப்பு சொல்லலாம்.
We get uncomfortable if we say the, you know, rapist is responsible. It's very easy for us to target the person who is the underdog. Otherwise, it questions our own selves. We'll have to say that I am part of the society who is creating rapists, and that's like self-blame. So I don't want to do that. So it's very easy to say this is her mistake, and it's her, and so it's somebody who is external. So that takes away a lot of responsibility from myself.
It's difficult to say straight away who is responsible, but I would always want the victim to be safeguarded.
I can't even think or conceive how women could have contributed to this situation that we are in today. I can't even begin to conceive. It's the men.
I wouldn't say it's equally people. The girl and the guy is equally responsible. I would definitely not say that. The guy and the society who's seeing you and putting the girl in such a situation it definitely has an upper hand in it. You definitely don't have the right to force yourself on a person like that, molest a person. There's a lot of agony, mental agony, physical abuse which is going in that person. It's definitely not right to do anything like that without that person's consent. You don't have the right.
It kind of stays with you for life. If you're a good girl, you want to grow up and be a good wife and a good mother and a good person at work. And the number one thing that a good girl does is avoids conflict.